Hi friends, in the last video we saw different types of data center tiers. Now in this video, let's go one step further. So before we start the data center tour, let me give you one task. Tell me, how will you select your house? What will be your main selection criteria? Generally, the two main criteria are technical and commercial evaluation. Let me make this task more simpler. Select which bedroom will you buy. Of course, anyone will select this particular bedroom. What did you do just now was sort of technical evaluation. So in technical evaluation, you will see if the rooms have leakage, how old is the construction, if there is a proper water supply, electric supply, right? Similarly, in commercial evaluation, you will generally see the budget. What is the location? Similarly, companies will have a similar criteria. They check both the parameters, technical and commercial. The technical evaluation is generally done by engineers, infrastructure consultants, structural auditors, and the commercial evaluation is done by the senior management team of your company. Now, these days, companies are aware how important IT is and they give utmost importance to select the data center. Assume for a moment you are a CTO, Chief Technical Officer of your company, and you have the opportunity to select the location of your data center. What will you do? You will generally check the two things: whether the site is protected from natural calamities like waterlogging, flooding, earthquake, whether it is a seismic zone or not, right? And you will also check the protection from man-made hazards, whether the area is sensitive, whether there are any local issues, if there is any airport that is coming in between, if there is a lot of industrial pollution. What is this? It is a floor plan of one bedroom apartment. So this is hall, this is bedroom, this is kitchen. Similarly, our data center also has a layout, and here it is for your reference. You can see here there are server rooms. How many server rooms are here? 3 server rooms are shown. Okay. These are the racks in which your servers are placed. Okay. See, this is the staging area. This is the NOC, Network Operation Center. Right. And this is your UPS room. This is your generator. Okay. Let's now move one step further. What is this? Storeroom. Why is storeroom required? So storeroom is required to keep whatever new hardware you receive. Even the old hardware that has to be returned is kept in a storeroom. Staging room. So whenever we get any new hardware or any new IT asset, it takes time for that asset to get acclimatized to the data center temperature. Also, since this hardware is new, you never know if there is any issue in that hardware that might cause your other assets in the server room to fail. Thus, generally, before moving to the server room, the assets are acclimatized. These assets are configured with new softwares. Those are thoroughly checked for any bugs. Those are tested and then only moved to the server room. So this all testing, configuration, this is all done in staging room. This staging room has got all other facilities like power, network, it has got fire protection and safety measures, right? What is this? This is the server room. This is the main room where all your IT assets are kept. Where are your IT assets kept? Those are kept inside the racks. Server room is a very secure environment. It is environmentally controlled facility which is monitored 24/7. The server room has got other facilities like fire protection, humidity controller, cold aisle and hot aisle containment. What is this? This is nothing but media storage room. In data center, you take backups. These backups are kept in tapes. Those tapes are kept in the fireproof. There are also some important documents that your company must be having. Those documents are also kept in a fireproof. And this fireproof is actually kept in a separate room. Why? Because if something goes wrong in your server room, then at least your backups and the important documents are stored and are saved in a controlled manner. UPS and battery room. What is UPS? As the name suggests, UPS is nothing but uninterrupted power supply. The power never interrupts. It never fluctuates. In case power from your main grid fails and the generator takes over, then it takes around a minute for the generator to start. In that 1 minute of glitch, your UPS makes sure that the power is not lost. Thus, UPS has got a battery backup to provide the necessary power. UPS and batteries can be combined in one room, or they can even be separate. UPS emits lot of electromagnetic waves and can affect your computer. Thus, it is always away from your server room. What is this? This is a generator room where your generator is located. Generator generally runs on a diesel, and there should be a sufficient diesel supply to run the generator. The diesel is stored in the diesel tanks, and the diesel tanks are located underground outside your data center building. What is this? Meet me room. Whom are you meeting here? You are actually meeting the outside world. Your data center is connected to the outside world using network links. Network links are provided by multiple ISPs. ISPs is nothing but internet service provider. These links are terminated here. These are the links which are terminated here, and from here it is then transferred to your data center. BMS room. Building monitoring system room. DC is very critical facility. It has to be monitored 24/7. The monitoring is usually done through cameras, temperature sensors, humidity sensors, access lock systems, water chillers. All these monitoring is happening through a separate room called BMS room. NOC room, Network Operation Center. You do lot of activities in your server room. What is the temperature of your server room? It is very low. It is around 19 to 22 degrees Celsius. Thus, it is practically impossible for any engineer or any person to sit in a server room for 8 to 9 hours in a day. Thus, the data center engineers sit in a separate room which is near to your server room. Some review questions. Tell me, where are the servers hosted? Servers are hosted in the server room. In which room ISPs terminate their links? They terminate in the MMR room. Why UPS room is always separate from server room? It is because it emits the electromagnetic waves which can affect your IT assets. That's it for today's lecture. Thank you for watching. See you in the next lecture.